Record types are very useful when designing domain models. This property here is a record. But how do we persist such a record when using Entity Framework Core? This is the definition of that record type. It specifies the parts of the author's name in the domain model of books. The definition is straightforward. But again, how do we persist it using Entity Framework Core? EF Core does not support records natively. That is natural. Entity Framework tracks entities while the record is an immutable value object by default. All I could do so far was to ignore the property until I find a way to persist it. If it were a common property type, I would just configure its mapping here. However, it is not a common property type, and this attempt would fail. This problem had no satisfying solution before Entity Framework Core 8. Starting with version 8, EF Core supports so-called complex types. Just specify it is a complex property, and EF Core will place its entire content in the same row as the containing entity. I'm configuring the author entity in this class. Consequently, the components of the personal name record would end up as fields in the author's table. Believe it or not, that was all I had to do to persist a record instance. Adding a migration works like a charm. No errors. Let me show you the migration. Three new columns are added to the author's table just as I predicted. This is so good that I could end the demo here as well. Adding a complex type to an entity worked out of the box. Complex types are not entities. EF Core will not secretly assign an identity to a complex type, as it used to do with owned types. The save changes will check the record's properties and issue an update statement if needed. It is super easy. Still, I have some objections. I don't like the naming scheme applied for complex types properties. EF Core tries to avoid name collisions. That makes sense. Still, I want better names for these fields. I have removed the migration because I want to customize it a bit. Please note that this step is entirely optional. Remember, EF Core can still track records, but only as part of a proper entity. Don't ask for more and you will live a happy life. Now, I want to customize the default mapping. Step inside the property configuration and add a lambda, which takes a complex property builder, and then start making refinements, like configuring the property named first. I find first name to be a more appropriate name for that column. I could also override the database type here as well. Configuring properties of a complex type works the same as with any other property. I will rename the middle names property too. Mind the plural middle names. There is also an opportunity to do more. Most book authors in the database will have no middle names anyway. On the other hand, the record defines non-nullable components. The empty string would indicate a missing middle name for a person. That is common in C# code where you will probably insist on always having objects. Still, we follow different concepts when designing a relational database. We commonly use null in a database field when a value is missing. How do we reconcile these two? The C# domain model and a relational database schema? Fear not. We can configure a value converter that does the job. I have designed this custom value converter to convert an empty string into a null and vice versa. I will have the best of both worlds, a non-null string in C# and a null field in the database. You should watch my previous video about value conversions if this puzzles you. Let me also tell EF Core to make this property nullable in the database. I'm eager to see the new migration. The third property will only require a nice column name. This is the result of the latest changes. The migration looks much better now. Column names are concise and the middle names column is nullable. I will query this table in a minute and you will see actual nulls there even though there were no nulls in the C# model. Before you see the data, I want to teach you another helpful technique that is more general than just persisting record types. I don't like to pile up configurations like this. Even this class is a separate configuration for the outer entity. It implements the IEntity type configuration interface from EF Core. Likewise, I tend to introduce a dedicated class to configure each complex type. This is my custom interface for that purpose. EF Core designers did not consider it helpful, so the library has no such interface. I can now replace this entire configuration with a call to my custom extension method that receives a complex property configuration object. It is an aesthetic change, but I like it better this way. The substantial result is what EF Core will save to the database when I give it a set of outer objects. All outers except Uncle Bob have their middle names missing. Their database fields are null, just as I wanted. I could end the video here. But would it be me if I didn't show you a true mastery of managing records with Entity Framework Core? Step into my office and meet the Release class. Look at this addition property here. I'm currently ignoring it in persistence. Entity Framework does not support properties like this right now. To begin with, it is an interface. You cannot just configure it with EF Core. I will use records to accomplish that. You will learn that technique now. The code will be challenging to grasp. Take your time to digest it. The entire source code, including parts beyond this video, is available on my Patreon page. Remember that every registered patron is helping hundreds of fellow programmers watch all the videos on my channel for free. Now let me tell you why you cannot just persist the implementations of this interface. Entity Framework supports table per hierarchy to persist polymorphic types, but such a type must still be an entity. The addition would need to have an identity. There would be a navigation property in the release and a foreign key in the database. Loading the release would require an inner join. That is crazy. An addition is just a value inside the book's release object. That is how I see it. Enter records. Do you know what this record is? It is a table per hierarchy representation of all classes that implement the IAddition interface. The discriminator property is the object's runtime type, either seasonal addition or ordinal addition. The rest depends on the discriminator. A seasonal addition would specify the season and the year. An ordinal addition would leave the season null and only populate the number. It is a common practice to leave complicated properties unpersisted if EF Core cannot support them. At the same time, you would prepare one or more helper properties that EF Core does support. That is where records come in as a great relief because they let you bundle several properties inside only one object. There will be no backing field for this property. Any instance would be created dynamically whenever EF Core needs it, such as during the save changes operation. I will define this method in just a minute. EF Core will also try to populate this property from the database. But this property has no state. Setting it will only cause a decoding into the proper addition. Now you see my plan. I will persist the representation property instead of the complicated interface above. Let me define those conversion methods first. In the best tradition of designing C# records, I will define these as extension methods. You can watch my other video about record types if you have any second thoughts about what I am doing now. Converting a domain object into a persistence representation is straightforward, if not too readable, and so is the reverse transformation. There is a lot of typing here, but both operations are pretty straightforward. They only check for the addition type and convert its content back and forth. This is what you should be looking at. The release class now only contains the state that EF Core supports. Note that this representation is private. Only EF Core will know it exists. Let's visit the persistence configuration then. I will keep ignoring the addition property. EF Core does not support it in its current form. I'm interested in configuring that private record as a complex type. I will configure it separately, which is already a common practice in this project. There's only one distinction to how I configured other properties so far. Entity Framework doesn't like properties too much. It likes their backing fields better. That makes sense if core works with the state. And so you must tell it to rely on the getter and the setter when you have a calculated property like this one. It is really not a big deal. This is finally where we configure the properties of the addition representation record. There are three properties to configure. I want to give them nice and meaningful column names. If you already know how Entity Framework Core maps a hierarchy of entity classes into a single table, then you will recognize the same mapping practice here. However, these property types are complex. I will need to specify value conversions as well. The discriminator object is a type, so I will use an appropriate converter I have prepared up front. I really think you should watch the previous video about value converters. I don't know if I could do anything with EF Core without value converters. You will find the link in the description. Year season is an enum. I have prepared another value converter for that. Finally, the number is just an int. EF Core can handle that on its own. This is the corresponding migration. All three fields are there. The type name as text, the number, and the enum name representing a season also as text. Only the season field is nullable just as expected. I'm querying the books. You will see all three new columns populated with meaningful data. When the discriminator is ordinal edition, the season field is null. When it is a seasonal edition, you see both the season and the year stored. And here is the bonus. The final code, which is available on my Patreon page, also maps this mysterious property named publication. That is also a record, but this time an abstract record. It is simulating a discriminated union. Some variants also contain other abstract record, the publication date. You see yet another set of three concrete record types derived from an empty abstract record. I have managed to persist all these records using the same trick you learned in this video. Complex types and value converters make modern Entity Framework Core a respectable persistence library. Subscribe to my channel and learn more about object-oriented and functional programming with the latest C#.